joy, prosperity, all that good stuff, and infinite abundance. Mm-hmm. Thank you guys, all of my tequilas, for coming back and joining me. I've noticed that you guys have been leaving me a lot of YouTube content, and you guys have been holding me accountable, and I really appreciate that. It just inspires me more. And the fact that I'm a Gemini and I own that, I may get, you know, caught up in the fact that I want to work on another project opposed to YouTube channel. But I freaking love you guys, and I love YouTube, and so I do miss you guys also when I'm not here. So I really appreciate all the people who inbox me, people who watch like some of my first videos ever that I didn't even think were public, but somehow they're still up and running. So thank you guys for that support. I love that, I need that, and let's keep it going. So if you are new to Takiya Talk, this is basically just a space I created for personal development, self-love, motivation, and just finding your purpose and going for it, right? Because a lot of the times we're really dope and we might get caught up in thoughts that are not serving us. We might get caught up in places, people that are not serving us. And so my job is to always redirect energy and to just plant a little seed, just sprinkle a little love, just to make you guys understand, just to get you guys to see that there is real, pure, genuine, sincere people out here, and then there are people who wish to usurp your energy. You know what that means, right? They basically want you to go from being conscious, smart, and dope to being low vibrational, unconscious, unaware of what's going on around you, and they'll do it slowly over time if you allow. But if you want my Takiya loves, if you want my babies, and you are here for this journey, it's not gonna happen. You know why? Because we are about practicing. First, we're gonna set standards. Then we're gonna practice keeping those standards. And you know how you keep those standards? You value them. It's not that you actually want things to be this and this way. It's that you really value and see the importance of it. And so it's going to be that way. And that's what we do here, baby. We make sure things stay in order, things are in order, so we can look awesome and we can spread the awesomeness that is from within us, which is the higher power, which is God, or whatever you want to call it, I don't know. But today, guys, let's just really talk about unity, right? Unity. And I say that because so often I can just go off into self-love and motivate you guys, you know, there, but it's a bigger picture that I want you guys to understand. You can love yourself. You can love yourself all day, right? But what happens when you're full of love and you're bursting out? What happens? You have a cup that is full. Like one of my awesome friends was telling me, I love how he said it. He was like, what happens when a battery is 100% full? And I was like, what happens? He's like, well, dead cells start to be created because it's overly charged, right? There has to be a balance of things, but when it's overly charged, you have to unplug, right? Or you have to use some of that juice up, right? So same thing with us humans. We have batteries, energy in our body, and some people are doing really well filling their cups up. Now, if you're one of them people and your cup runneth over, how you out here? How could you possibly be out here not sharing all of that goodness? Okay? Some people tend to shy away from it. They get scared of that much power. But you have to know that there's people out here with broken cups. Their cup is not able to run it over because there are so many cracks in the cup that whatever you try to pour into them, it just seeps out. So take a moment right now. If your cup is running over, thank God. Thank you, God, that I'm able to be a light. Thank you, God, for the purpose of my creation. And thank you, God, because hopefully, just maybe possibly, what I'm saying is going to catch someone's attention and get them to think, right? But no worries, guys. If your cup is broken, or you know you're not sure how to pour out or where to, no worries, baby. We're gonna get right into it, right? the first thing I want to talk about is having a broken cup, right? Because we are all here with a purpose to help each other out and to be in alignment and synchronicity as a collective whole, right? But sometimes it's so hard to unify because we've been programmed into thinking that we're all different, separate, in the vision, right? So instead of multiplying, we divide. And that's not the correct math. So, where does all of this even come from, right? Well, from the time you're a child, those first 7 years of your life, when your subconscious is running rapidly, recording, sponging things up, most of those experiences, most of those things that you've seen and heard tend to become your belief system for your future current reality, unless you become so aware that you start a healing process for yourself early on in life, which usually we catch it by the time we're in our early or mid-20s, if you're lucky enough. But I've heard that a lot of people don't catch it until they're in their 40s. So thank you. If you're here watching this video right now, you are ahead of the game, baby. Period. So, my tequila loves, when it comes to a broken cup, right, you can't be of service and help other people, right? You can't unify, right? And unifying is one of the greatest things, to co-evolve with others, to be of assistance, to service, right? You have to really start to do some shadow work. You have to really start to go within self and identify all of those experiences that may have been painful for you. You don't have to necessarily, dwell on it, but acknowledge that these things happened and that maybe possibly the reason it's so hard for you to heal is because you've been holding on to this pain, right? What happens when you hold on to things that are painful? What happens to hair when you hold on to hair that is split ends? Well, it just becomes more and more damaged until you do what? Cut it off. So, you may possibly need to do some type of self-evaluation where you're looking around your surroundings. Is this really what I want to wake up and see every day? Is this really what I want to go to sleep to? The people you're entertaining, even the music you're listening to. Am I really a bitch and a hoe? Excuse me, am I really this N-I, you know what I'm going with that, man type of man that the hip-hop media portrays me to be? If you're not, please don't start this, oh, consciously I know what I'm doing. Well, subconsciously, the big booty stripper video, the drugs, the jewelry, all of this is still seeping into your brain, okay? So when you have these desires and you're just like, oh, I don't even like women with plastic bodies. But you've been on Instagram for the last 3 hours looking at plastic bodies. So guess who's going to end up dating a plastic body? It's all a self-program, guys. And someone out there knows that, right? Someone out there is causing us to think these things. But it's up to you to be the one to
be aware and to reprogram yourself. You have to know that you are greater than any of the things that you've ever been through. You're greater than what you see and hear in front of you, because you have the power to redirect your energy and to create a better reality for yourself, okay? So don't ever let anybody take your power. Like my girl B says, because y'all are so corny with that, what? Illuminati. Let her be, yo. Let her shine. Now, when you start to really want this healing deep within, you'll actually, you know, do that self-evaluation and check around you, and you'll see that there are so many things that are not in alignment with your values that you have to cut them out. If you don't cut them out, then you can't really go any farther on your journey. You'll just be stuck at that one spot. It's not that these things are necessarily stopping and hurting you. It's you. You are your biggest enemy sometimes. The way how you procrastinate, the way how you hold on to things, the way how you even tend to overanalyze, overthink. That is what is hurting you. You. So,
Are you ready to stop blaming other people? Are you ready to be fully accountable? Like, yeah, I know I did pick up the phone when they called. Yeah, I know I did hop in the car with them. Yeah, I know I did get that, you know, freaking bottle and drink it straight down when I don't even drink like that. And now I'm drunk. And now I don't even remember what happened. Okay. And I got some real crazy stories, y'all, but whew, another day, another day, another day. I just want you guys to really understand that you are very powerful, and pain can be used as, it can be used as a tool for growth, you know, like growing pains, right? So think about those people that come around you. Think about those places that you've been going that may not be so self-serving to you, but it's really serving a purpose for the people around you, right? But when you're in a good quality company, you service each other. It's not always going to just be a one-way street, okay? So remember that, guys. And it's not that your service has to be just as great as that person's, but if there is interaction going on and it's a mutual understanding, nobody should be in their fiefdoms, okay? But the broken cup is still a very beautiful cup. It is a sign of a warrior in the making, because the cup is not shattered, it's not falling apart, it just needs a little bit of plaster, just needs a little bit of tape on it, and it'll be all right. Now, the cup that's running over, oh, that cup needs to pour out. That cup needs to be of service to other people. And the only way that cup is able to run it over is because there was so many different things put into it. Love, respect, discipline, determination, honesty, meekness, humbleness, kindness, whatever it is you like, metaphysics, quantum physics, the sociology of nature. Is that even a topic? I just made it up. See, I see where I'm going with this, the psychology of the human brain. Like, really dive deep into the things that you love. And when you put more of you in this cup and it runs over, I'm telling you, some of everybody named Mama gonna want to taste a little bit of that cup. They gonna want to taste a little sip of that cup. But it ain't for everybody. Everybody can't come and drink water at the well with you, okay? Because some people, you got that one or two people that's gonna be looking around when nobody else is looking. They gonna whoop, put some pills in the water. They gonna whoop, put some shit in the water and throw everybody off, right? It's always those bad apples that try to come and ruin the whole bunch. So you have to really be into you, to have discernment, to know, like, okay, right up in there, my anxiety, right up in there, my intuition just started going crazy, okay? I just hopped right in his car, and out of nowhere, I started getting those energy signals from my ancestors, from the spirit guides, from the universe, like, oh, girl, you know dang on well, you backtracking if you do this, okay? So start to pay attention to your energy for real. It's not you. It's not always that you're in fear. Because usually when you're in fear, you feel it right up in here, right? In your heart. That is also an indicator that it is you that is, I won't say being delusional, but your emotions are coming to control you in that moment. You have to take a deep breath. You have to, woo, sigh. You literally have to, like, have a moment of prayer with the Most High. You literally have to, whatever your faith is, whatever you do. I like to pray. If I feel any bit of anxiety, I got to get you up out of there ASAP. And after that, I feel so much awesome acknowledging how I feel and telling, you know, Source, come and fix this. Come and clean my heart. Come and clean my spirit right now. Because this is not a reflection of the most magnificent, greatest, most powerful energy there is, which is God energy, okay?
When you tap into your consciousness within, you are tapping into that God-like energy, goddess, God body, you know? Little God, whatever you want to call it. We have to really own our powers, guys. And we have to own our purpose. You cannot be in fear. You know what I'm saying? Intuition, though, it is a really awesome tool. When up in there is not right, you might be out, you might be around somebody. Pay attention to that, okay? Because it is your body telling you, get the heck up out of there, get away from it. And, you know, if you don't, what's going to happen? The results may be less than pleasant, less than positive, may not be what you wanted. Might have set yourself up for the okey-doke again. And then you'll be somewhere crying and not being accountable. You gotta hold yourself accountable, okay? Change starts with who? Self. It doesn't start with, oh, if this guy just treats me better, oh, if this job just pays me a little more. No, baby, it starts with you. You know what I'm saying? You know that you're broken. You know that you need healing. So, there is no way in heaven's good gates you should be entertaining anybody, anything outside of self at that moment, okay? You know, maybe there's a guy and he's cute and he gives you nice gifts. But you know that you shouldn't really entertain that either, because at the very moment you say that these gifts are more pleasurable than the standards I really set for myself, you're losing. Just because someone comes along and, you know, they try to add onto your life, you have to pay attention to what they're adding. Is it real wealth? Is it real value? Or is it just materialistic things, okay? Because materialistic things don't last that long. And usually, if a person is very materialistic, the relationship between you two, if you're more on a deep end, it probably gonna hit the fan, okay? I'm just letting you guys know, it is freaking hot out here. Oh my God. I wanted to be in the sunlight because I love when the sun kisses my face, but it is hot. And I'm dancing a little bit because I had a lot of water and I think I gotta go pee. Oh, I am so nuts. But I'm a Gemini. I own that, okay? But listen, guys, I just want you to know that you could become broken from interacting with broken people. They might not even know they're broken, or they may do, but they don't want your help to fix them. They want to be how they are. You better not entertain that shit. You better go on about your way before you be pulling yourself out the mud again and you already was upped up, okay? Understand how God sets certain things in front of you. They're called temptations, silly. And if you are tempted, which you will always be in this lifetime, you have to remember not to fall for the trap, okay? It may be that thing that you really like, and now you don't even got to spend any money on it. Or it may be, you know, you don't even have to drive your own car anymore. Whatever the benefits of a situation may incur, is it worth your peace of mind, sis? Is it worth your peace of mind, bro? No, honestly. Because I see so many people settling, and then they end up broken. And then they go to another person like that. How the heck does two damaged people walk around trying to freaking love each other? They don't. They out there cheating, and they out there still trying to damage other people. So be careful, if you're broken, not to go and cause more damage to yourself. Okay? Start to love yourself with all your strength, all your might. And you know how you love yourself? By loving the one who sent you here with a purpose and a plan that is greater than something you could not ever even really understand. God, okay? Turn within and find your spiritual faith, okay? It doesn't have to really be about religion, okay? Even when it comes to Christianity, it's not about religion. I'm kind of really so sick of people saying, oh, you know, they said Jesus was white and the white man lied. And look, guys, if you're going to make an excuse based off of a well-known lie, then just don't even try to walk and talk the talk, okay? do what you're going to do, but don't discourage people that are real believers who don't dive so deep into the real truth that they can, like, dismantle the lies quickly, that they can see through the freaking veil. They can see through the illusions. God is real. And when you get up with God, baby, ain't no more brokenness. Ain't no more procrastinating. You got things to do, and you're going to do them now. Peace.